In this video, I want to take you through how I created this image and specifically how I used some of the new Lumion features to do this. The project model is the Case Study House number 22 or the Stall House by Pierre Koenig. This is one of the most famous houses from the Case Study House program from the 50s and 60s. And also, it's known for having some famous photographs from Julius Shulman. I downloaded this model from the 3D warehouse and imported it into Lumion using the live sync feature. Next, I started by trying to frame the view which I was going for, which was very similar from the classic modern photographs, but I wanted the image ratio to be a little bit more vertical. So for this, I used the ratio tool inside of Lumion and defined the specific ratio for this image. Next, I continued by adding the basic effects of my image. These were first the 2-point perspective effect, next, the real skies effect, the color correction effect, and then the ray tracing effect. These are the basic tools we will work with. Now, for the real skies, one of the newest features inside of Lumion is that we can add our own HDRI. This seems like something we should have seen in the first updates of the program, but I'm just glad it's finally here. Here, we can modify the sun intensity, background brightness, sky brightness, and heading. First, I will import my HDRI. In this case, I'm using the HDRI from the team at 3D Collective. I import the image and start adjusting the parameters. For the direction of the HDRI, I know I want an image that doesn't have a direct sunlight and just has a really nice and soft ambient light. So I'll hide the actual sun behind the building and place it in such a way that it lights up the living room of the house. This is, of course, a composition trick if you're working in a day image and don't necessarily want contrast with artificial lighting. Try to illuminate the middle part of your image. That way, your eye will travel to the middle. Next, I adjusted the sky background and sun intensity. I always adjust these bit by bit and try to test out what works best. In this case, I placed the sky brightness in 204, the background brightness in 80%, and the sun intensity in 25%. If you're a bit confused, let me explain to you real quick what each of these values does. The sun intensity solely manages the direct sunlight, so it doesn't change the texture of my HDRI. The background brightness works with the actual texture of the HDRI, and the sky brightness is the light emitted from the general sky of the HDRI. By playing with these parameters, you can get completely different results like these ones. This is the image before the real skies, and this is the image after the real skies. As soon as I have my real skies adjusted, I'll go on to Lumion to add all the necessary vegetation, adjust materials, and assets so my image can look great. I won't bore you with everything I added to the image, but some of the most important things were the following. First, the vegetation. We have the foreground vegetation, which is primarily interior plants placed along the pool. Then the background vegetation, which was placed using bushes from the Lumion library. Next, I adjusted some basic materials like the concrete floor, the metal roof, and the frames, and also the color of the pool. These are the settings for the water material in the pool. Here, I wanted the water to feel a bit dirty, so I added some water density. Finally, I added some people. This was key to add a story to the image and also give a sense of scale. This is the image before adding assets, and this is after. After all this, we're going to open our color correction effect. Here, we will see our second big feature in this new version of Lumion, which is the possibility to add your own personal LUT inside of Lumion. This was probably one of the biggest downsides inside of Lumion in terms of color correction, and I'm so glad it was added. In the future, I would also love to see more color correction features like general color grading, selective color correction, auto white balance, and why not, an AI color correction feature. Now, for those of you that have no idea what LUTs are, you can say that these are kind of groups of adjustments that come in this LUT format and apply a filter to your image. This can help you when you want your renders to have some consistency and be coherent among them. Lumion has some built-in LUTs that are really, really good, but in this case, I will use the Sony Cine4 film LUTs that I downloaded from Motion Array. I can adjust the LUT intensity if it's too strong, but for this image, I'll leave it at 100%. Next, I'll increase the temperature and decrease the tint. This is because I want my image to have a certain feel and colors where we feel this warm LA sun and also we have these green shadows. Maybe if the tint was too magenta or the temperature too cold, it would feel out of place. Next, I want to slightly increase the exposure and also the contrast. I'm going to also increase the highlights and increase the vibrance just a bit. This is the image before the color correction and this is after. We are going to add a fog effect. Here, I'll increase the fog density to 1.22, leave the fall off at 0, and put the brightness at 0.62. I'll also select the color of my fog since the sun is at a very low point. I know that the general color of the sunlight is very red, and I want to emphasize this with the fog. This is the image before adding fog, and this is after. Finally, we're going to add our depth of field. I will focus the image towards the living room and add a subtle blur. After this, I'll render my image, render it also with all of the render channels just in case, and add it onto Photoshop. Here, I'll use the lighting channel to add some extra detail to the roof. So I went to my material ID layer, selected the roof, then went onto my lighting layer and created a mask. I set this layer to lighten and lowered the opacity. Then I opened the camera raw filter and started doing some adjustments. First, I added some light adjustments, increasing the exposure, lowering the contrast, increasing the shadows, and lowering the highlights. This is because my image was too dark before, and this brought out some things that were very, very dark. Next, in the color tab, I increased the temperature, increased the tint, increased the vibrance just a bit as well. Then in the effects tab, I increased the texture, clarity, and lowered the dehaze value. Finally, in the color mixer, I increased the saturation of the pool and also of the red colors in the image. This is the image before passing it through Photoshop, and this is after. And this is the image from the first render that we did down to the final image. So these are definitely some really promising features in this new version of Lumion, and definitely make me want to start playing with Lumion much, much more. What do you think? What features is Lumion missing that you would want? Comment down below. Also, if you want to see more Lumion videos, check out this Lumion playlist right here. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.